Hello everyone, thank you for watching Graded Picture Playground. In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to create lower third in legacy title inside of Premiere Pro CC. Before I continue, I want to please remind you to subscribe so that you don't miss any upload. Hit the subscribe button and click on the notification bell to get notified when new video is uploaded. What is a lower third? A lower third is a graphic overlay placed in the title self lower area of your screen. It may necessarily not be the entire lower third area. Well, let me not bore you with much talk. We're going to create this lower third with the legacy title inside of Premiere Pro CC. So let's begin. To get the lower third started, you hit on File, New, then you come to Legacy Title. If you've not seen the tutorial on how to use and locate the legacy title, hit the card icon to see the tutorial on how to locate and use the legacy title. So the moment you click on the legacy title, it gives you a box where you can name your title. This one, we gave it lower third. Then immediately you create a new title. It will take the timeline setting. You hit on OK. This will open up. So this is the lower third. From this spot here to down this way is lower third. And most often, it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to create your lower third to occupy the entire lower third space. So from this very end to this end, down this way is your lower third in the television industry. Let's begin by clicking on the rectangular tool and come down this way and create something like this. So let's not make this too long. Let's just make it this way. Then we push it down here. Let's leave it here for now. So we create another one, another rectangular icon. Let's draw it like this. This should be a bit longer. Then it shouldn't be wide as such. So let's make it this way and bring it down here. So let's align it here and stretch it out a bit. Then let's take the selection tool and readjust this. Then let's bring this one down. Then let's create a third rectangular shape like this. Let it be of the same size like the previous one. So we stretch it out. We control A to highlight all of them and push them down this way. Let's take it up to this spot. So let's reduce it a bit. Let's have something like this. Now this is what we have created. So the first thing we need to do, let's change this color to red. Change this to red. Let's change this to black by clicking on this and we come here, select black, leave it on that black. So this should be on white. Let's reduce this white a bit. Then let's stretch out this black. So let's bring this down. So we have this three layer comprising of different color. So let's create another rectangular shape and let's make this thin and bring it here to the edge this way. The essence of me taking this procedure is for you to understand how lower thirds can be created inside of your legacy title. So we make this come this way. Still have to bring it down. Let it align properly. And the next thing now is to also change this color. Let's pick this and make it red. as well. The other thing is to create another rectangular. Let's make this red, as it's already taking it. So these are ways you create your lower third. So I will fast forward this so that you see how it goes. You've already seen the basic on establishing how to create it. I will fast forward this area, then continue when we get to the next phase. So now let's start inserting right up. Let's take, for instance, the first one is to click on new tutorial. Let's write new tutorial. We'll change that color to white. Let's place it here. So we have to change the font by searching for Beba's new. So we have this. We extend the aspect ratio. So we place it here like this. The way this can come. We have created that. So the next one is, let's say, weekly video upload. This is another. So we take click on the selection tool. Let's reduce this and place it here as being the font of this. Let's bring this down. Can use the up and down arrow key to align it properly. So we can click on the aspect ratio to make it line up to this point. So the next thing now is, let's say we are making this like a broadcast. Next thing is to type live. I believe you must have seen some of these lower thirds, something similar or that looks like this in your TV live program. We have something like that. The next one is to let me use the acronym of my channel GPP, which is great for graded picture playground GPP. So we change this very color to black. Radically, you can do your own design to suit the purpose of what you want to create. So we can have something like this. So you can as well place your logo if you so desire. But for the benefit of this tutorial, so we make this go like this. Then the next one is to create, let's say, time that the broadcast is going on. Let's say 6 a.m. So we change the font color to white because it's going to be laid on a black background. Can reduce the font, then bring it here and place just like this. And the next information that would follow will now be underneath here. Let's say my name and my Instagram handle. So I write Valentine Ose. This is just an idea of how a lower third for television broadcasting is created. You come down, let me use this font. Let me make it bold. Aleph is the font that I'm using. You can use any font so long it meets the purpose of what you are designing. So align that. We change the color to black because we are laying it on a white background. So for it to be outstanding and for it to be properly pronounced, you can use any color so long it goes out. Then let's create a tiny rectangular shape to create a kind of demarcation in between my name and that of my social media. Let's place it here. So let's place it here and change the color to red. Let's pick the exact red. Click on OK. This is it. So we've created something. So my Instagram handle is at GPP Cinemas. So that is it. I'll bring it here. So this is it. We've created it. So each time you create either a title or a graphics, just as we're doing, the moment you close it here, it immediately goes into your project bin. So let's align this properly by clicking on Control A. Control A, we get it aligned. And let's move it so that it will be uniform on both sides. So this is it. We've created a graphical lower third as the definition implies. Let's now bring it to your timeline and we have it here. So we've created a graphical lower third. So you can now apply your transition effects. Let's go to effects, video transition. Let's go to slide and select push. You place it at the beginning and you place this at the end. So you have something like this. But in a situation whereby you want that effect to go back from where it entered, you click on the effect here and it will highlight on your effects and control. Just click on reverse and that will make it reverse to the position that it came from. So that is it. And let's click here. We have something like this. So that is how you create the lower third just as the TV station creates theirs. If you like this tutorial, give it a thumb up, and if this is your first time on this channel, hit on the subscribe button and click on the notification bell to get notified when new video is uploaded. I am Valentine Ose. I have been your guide on Graded Picture Playground. Thanks for watching.